win a pot of gold on Card Shark. And here's the host of Card Shark, Jim Perry.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Hi, thank you. Welcome to Card Sharks. We're in the middle of a nice match with some nice people, and I do hope you'll play along. Make your decisions as we get to the cards. Janice and Ann, load in the cards, if you will. You can see we have a game in progress with these card sharks. Lois Lambert, our champion. Hi, Lois.
Hi, Jim.
Nice to see you.
Thank you.
Won't you again remind us about yourself?
Yeah, I'm a video consultant. I'm originally from Chicago, and I have a beautiful and wonderful daughter of 6 years old.
Isn't that nice? And you have won $6,350 in cash.
That's wonderful.
Good chances. And our challenger, Angelo Aguiar. Hello, Angelo.
How
nice to see you.
How's everything?
Got some friends out there, Angelo. Tell us about yourself.
Well, I'm from New York, and I'm a teacher. And as I said before, I love to play a lot of tennis. And recently, where I live, we have a tennis club, and I'm third in the ladder.
Ooh. Well, what level is that?
They put
B. What does that mean, a B player?
Well, there's A, B, and C, and I'm a little bit away from A.
Ah. Would you believe X? Good luck in the match to each of you. Each player has their own deck of 52 playing cards, shuffled and cut before we go on the air. Lois, the champion, will play the upper cards, the red cards. Angelo, the challenger, plays the lower cards, the blue cards. And as you can see, we have a game in progress. Lois needs 4 cards. Angelo needs 3. That's the object of the game, to work your way across the board, predicting whether each card is higher or lower than the one that precedes it. Before you can begin calling high-low in the cards, you must win a high-low toss-up question based on a poll of 100 people. And we play the best 2 out of 3. Angelo, the challenger, won the first game in the match. Lois, you need 2 in a row if you want to get to the money cards. Lois, the question to you as we left off. We asked 100 married women, if your husband gave you 12 roses, would you feel flattered or suspicious? How many women said they would be suspicious?
No. I think that most women would be flattered. I'd be flattered. I'm not married, but I'd be flattered. I'd say 70 would be flattered.
70. Now, the question is, how many women said they would be suspicious?
Oh, I'm sorry. So 30 would be suspicious.
30. Your math is marvelous.
Oh,
30
yeah.
It is. Okay. Angelo, she says 30 out of 100 would be suspicious rather than flattered. Higher or lower?
I think women would be flattered. They really wouldn't take that as under suspicion. I have to go just a little bit lower.
Lower than that. Just if it is lower, you go to the board first. If not, it'll be lowest. The actual number of married women who would be suspicious if their husband gave them 12 roses is 18. Very much lower. Angelo. Angelo, we left off with a base card of a 9. As you move that freeze bar over, you won the question. You have the right to change that base card if you'd like.
Yeah, I want to change it, of course.
Here's the next card off the top of your deck. You must play this. It is a big ace. Great change.
Okay, we're going down. Gotta go down.
Lower than an ace.
Gotta go down.
It is a king.
I'm still going downtown.
Gonna continue. He's not freezing. Lower than a king. It's a jack. Now.
I'm going to take the A-train downtown.
Downtown.
Right.
You can tell that's a New Yorker.
Right.
If this is lower than a jack, we have a new champion on Card Sharks. For the win,
yes! It's a
congratulations.
Thank you.
Lois, thank you. You're leaving us with $6,350. Not bad at all. You're a 5 champion. Thank you, Lois. Angelo, come on down. Congratulations.
If he was a woman, I'd hug him.
We'll just shake hands, all right? We'll be right back to play the money cards right after this commercial message.
Why buy
it? We are a new champion again. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
You got $200 now at $100 a game for winning the match. Ready to go for the big dollars?
I'm ready to go for the big money. That's
right. Big money. Let's open the board and get to the money cards. A lot of money up there, Angelo. Get up here. $200 you won in the game, yours to keep. Now we're going to give you new money to play with. Brand new deck of cards all shuffled and cut. This time you're going to bet that money, starting on the bottom line with $200 and these 3 cards. When you move up to the second level, we add another $200 of betting money, and again, 3 more cards. $50 minimum bets until you get to the top card, the big bet. There you must bet at least half the dollars. All set?
I'm ready to go.
Here's $200. Good luck. Yeah, let's root them home. Let's do it. Here's your first of two base cards if you need it. It's a
Whoa,
seven.
I'm going to change that.
All right, you must play this one. It is... Oh, an eight.
Not much start, better.
Let's see if we can get it better.
I'm gonna bet 100 that it's lower.
That's a big bet right off the bat on an
100,
eight.
Yeah, I'm going for the big
$100 money. Lower than an eight? Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Get it. To the floor.
Yeah.
Yeah. Great bet. $300
okay.
To the floor.
300. All 300. Next spot is going to be higher.
Whole thing?
All 300. Higher.
$300.
Right.
Higher than a four. And it is. It's a 10.
All right. That's
$600. $600 and a 10, Angelo.
Yeah. That's rough. I'm going to bet 200 that it's no face card showed yet. 200 that it's lower.
Lower. $200. Lower than a 10. And it is.
Yeah.
It's a 7.
Woo!
$800.
Angelo.
Out of a tough card now.
That's
seven.
A tough
we
card.
Move it up. We give you the other $200 of betting money. You've got $1,000, Angelo.
Yep.
And
I'm going to bet 100 that it's higher. Face card.
Got to get a better card for $100 higher than
gotta
a 7. It's a 9.
$1,100.
Three cards to go.
I don't know. Still no face card, so I'm going to bet 200 that it's 200 that it's higher. It's got to be a face card.
Well, against the odds, $200
right.
Against the
face
odds,
card.
Higher than a
face
9.
Card.
Oh, no, it's an 8. And you're down to $900. No, the odds didn't work for you that time, Angelo. What's this card with $900 and an 8?
It's a bad card. I'm only going to bet 100, and I'm going to go higher again. It's got to be a
face card. Let's see
your
face card this time.
It's got to be a face card.
$100.
$100.
Higher than an 8? No!
What's a 5?
Down to 800. You've had some tough cards.
Tough cards.
You must bet at least 4. You can bet more. You've got 8. You've got a 5. What's your bet?
I'm going to bet half, 400, that the next card is higher.
All right, let's pull it out. Let's get it back up to that 4.
It's
got to
be that face card, Jim. It's got to be
higher than a 5 for $400.
No, it's a 3.
Tough cards.
Tough cards.
But $400 and the 200 for the game is not bad. That's $600, Angelo. Come on down here. And you're still here.
I'm still here. That's right.
That's the important thing. We'll meet a new challenger right after we take time out for this commercial message. All right, Angelo, let's meet a new challenger now as Janice gets two new decks of cards dealt out. Here's our next challenger on Card Sharks. Julie Cardenas, right? Julie, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
Why don't you tell us something about yourself?
I'm originally from Minnesota, a small town, and I've been in Southern California for nearly 4 years now. I'm a flight attendant for a major airline, hoping to win lots of money.
Good. Would you like to travel if you won lots of money?
Yeah, well, I do enough of that on my job.
I can't say as a blame. Stay home for a while, right?
Right.
A pretty blonde from Minnesota. Isn't that unusual?
No, well, not blondes in Minnesota aren't too unusual.
Nice to have you here with us, Julie.
Thanks.
Good luck in the match. You'll play the lower cards, the blue cards, while Angelo, the champion, plays the upper cards, the red cards. Angelo, we asked 100 men, which do you prefer, a woman who plays hard to get or a woman who gives in easily? How many men prefer a woman who plays hard to get?
I like it easy myself, but I think there are about... Today, there's about 35 men would say they like women that are hard to get.
35 out of 100 like a woman to play hard to get, Julie. Higher or lower?
I think most men are going to like a little more of a challenge. I'm going to go higher.
Say higher.
Higher.
The actual number of men who prefer a woman who plays hard to get is 51. It is higher, Julie. Wow. Julie, they did like the challenge, and you're starting with a 4.
Good card. The next one will be higher.
Higher than a 4. It's a 7.
Good.
Remember, you can freeze. And you'll freeze right there as you move the freeze bar over. Can't take that card away from you. Julie, we took a confidential poll of 100 married women and asked them, do you ever get so curious that you go through your husband's pants pockets? How many married women admitted they do?
I don't think too many women are going to go through their husband's pockets. I don't know. I hope they find better things to do. I'd say 25.
If they go through their pockets, they might find better things to do.
Yeah,
25.
Right.
Angelo, higher or lower?
I think that they do go through their pockets, and it's going to be higher.
You think
higher? If anything, they're looking for money.
That's generally what we figured the point would be. The actual number of married women who go through their husband's pants pockets is 22. Not higher, Julie. You almost had it right on the button. Julie, now you can change that 7 if you'd like. You didn't like it before.
Yeah, please change it.
Next card off the top of the deck is another 7. Got to play that one.
Okay, I think the next card will be higher.
Higher than a 7. It's a jack.
The next card will be lower, Jim.
Lower than a jack? No, it's a king. It's not lower. You lose both of them back to the base card. Angelo, we'll look at your base card. You've got an 8. You cannot change it. You didn't win the question. You got to play it.
That 8 got me before, too. I'm going to stay higher.
Higher.
Got to be higher.
Still looking for a face card in the deck.
I'm still looking for a face card.
Higher than an 8? No, it's a 4. Janice will fill in the spaces, and we go to you with a question, Angelo. Our man on the street went to Italy, where he stopped 100 women on the streets of Rome. How many of those 100 women on the streets of Rome were wearing slacks?
Oh. I know all the women here in America today are wearing slacks, and I really don't know the trend in Italy, but I think it would be the same, so I would venture to say it's 55 were wearing slacks.
55 out of 100 were wearing slacks, Julie. Higher or lower?
I think more. I think the answer will be lower.
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 Mm-hmm. The actual number of Roman women who were wearing slacks is 48. Lower, Julie. Julie, what do you think of that 7?
Oh, please change it.
And we have another 7.
Oh,
my goodness. 1, 2, 3, 7.
7. Higher. Lower. Lower.
You're going against the odds.
Yes.
Lower than a 7, and it is not lower. It's an 8. You'd have gone with the odds. Angelo, you're still looking at an 8. Call this card.
I'm still looking for a face card, Jim. I got to go higher.
Higher
Big
than
face
an 8.
Card. It's got to be there.
It's a king.
Yes. That's the one I was looking for.
Angelo.
That is a face card.
Yes, just in case you've forgotten. That's a
that's
face
a
card,
face
Angelo.
Card.
Yes, that's right.
Okay. That's
you've
beautiful.
Got a king. What do you got to do now?
I'm going to go downtown again.
Downtown.
Go
lower.
Lower.
It is. It's a 9.
That's rough. That's rough. One question left. I'm going to freeze.
You'll freeze.
I'm going to freeze, yeah.
He needs 2 cards. We fill in the spaces. Julie needs 3. We're at the 4th and final question. It's sudden death. Someone has to win with this play of the cards. Julie, we asked 100 men, have you ever worn lipstick? How many men said yes?
I can only think of like a costume ball that they wear lipstick. I'd say it's going to be low.
We just figured under
20.
Any circumstances. You say 20 out of 100 men have worn lipstick, Angelo. What do you think, higher or lower?
You know, that depends where you ask those men.
Yeah. Just 100 men at random.
I think it's going to be lower. A lot lower. I have never worn lipstick in my life.
You say lower.
So I say
you've never worn lipstick?
No.
It goes so well with basic black. Well, the actual number of men who have worn lipstick is 18. It's lower. Angelo, you got it. Now, sudden death, Angelo, you've got a 9. You're entitled to change it and try to turn these 2 cards over. But if you make a mistake, Julie wins. However, you can force Julie to play off the 7. She would have to turn over 3 cards to win, or it's yours. What are you going to do, play or pass?
Honey, have you ever played football? Because I'm passing you the ball right now.
Passing the ball right now.
Okay.
Julie, 1 mistake, and Angelo wins. If you turn all 3 of them over, you've got the first game of the match. Start calling.
Okay, I'll go higher.
Higher than a 7. It's an 8. 1/3 of the way there.
Lower.
Lower than an 8. It's a 5. This is higher. Julie wins the first game of the match. If not, it belongs to Angelo for the win. Yes, it's a 10. She did it. Congratulations, Julie. Put the pressure on you, and you were equal to it. Game number 1 to the challenger. We'll be right back with the next game of the match right after this.
Miss O'Malley.
The challenger, Julie, leads 1-0 with 1 game and $100. And Angelo, you need this game. You want to hang on to that championship. Deal out the cards, if you will, Janice. The same 2 decks of cards, and as I've said often, and it's true, if you can remember what cards have been played with your deck, it might help your strategy. Angelo, question to you. We asked 100 women, would you rather be governor of your state with all that power or the First Lady of the United States? How many women said they would rather be First Lady of the United States?
you know, First Lady is known throughout the world, and that esteem and that everybody looking at you, I think women want that. And I would say to be the First Lady, 70.
70 out of 100 would rather be First Lady of the United States than the governor of their state, Julie, higher or lower?
I'd rather be the First Lady, but I think the number will be lower.
You say lower?
Yeah.
Well, I'll find out as you will.
So, yeah.
And I think, I'm curious to find out the answer to this one. The actual number of women who would prefer being First Lady to being governor is 77, not lower. You got it, Angelo.
All right.
Your base card, Angelo, is
okay.
A 10. You want to play that or change it?
That 10 is tough. I'm gonna try and go change it. Please change it, honey.
Change it
to a better card. Yeah.
The change
okay.
To a jack.
Okay. Let's go back downtown.
Downtown.
Okay.
Lower than a jack. No, it's a queen. Cards have not liked you here. Ooh. Julie, your base card. It's a 6. Got to play that one.
Okay, I'll go higher.
Higher than a 6. It's a 9. You're free right there as we fill in the space for Angelo. We go to you with a question, Julie. We asked 100 women on the beach in Malibu, California. Right now, if a man walked up and pinched you on the fanny, would you slap him? How many women said they would slap him?
I'd slap him. But, I think the number probably would be pretty high. That's getting a little out of hand.
65 out of 100 would slap him if he tried to pinch. Angelo?
I don't know. I think a woman would be so shocked by being pinched and scared, she might curse him out. But I don't think she'll smack him. Although, again, it's lower.
Lower. The actual number of women on the beach who said they would slap a man who pinched them is 45. It's lower. Angelo, yeah.
Okay.
We're looking at a jack, Angelo.
I got to go lower. I'm going lower.
Going to play the jack and say lower, and this time it is 57.
That's a terrible card, Jim. And I'm going to freeze.
You'll freeze.
I'm going to freeze.
We've got a tie. Both players need 3 cards to win. Angelo needs this game to tie up the match. Angelo, we asked 100 newlywed men. These are all men who have been married for less than 6 months. Since your wedding, have you brought flowers home to your wife? How many newlywed men said yes?
But only 6 months being married?
6 months married.
Shoot, they're still in love after 6 months, you know? So I think the question is how many
said yes, they have brought flowers home since the wedding.
Oh, I
6
would,
months.
That's, I would say 85 men said they have brought
85 since the wedding you brought home flowers, Julie, higher or lower?
Oh, there are a lot of romantic men, but I'm going to go lower.
You say lower?
Yeah.
The actual number of newlywed men who have given their wife flowers is 47. Very much lower, Julie. I must say, that was a surprise.
Oh,
you're looking at a 9. Wait, change it, please. 2, a 10. A little bit better card.
Lower.
Lower than a 10. No, it's a jack. It's higher. Great for Angelo to play off the 7 and call this.
Whoa, I've gotten all kinds of face cards before, and that's just like that 8. I'm going to go, got to go higher.
Higher.
I'm going to go higher.
Higher than a 7?
Higher.
Yes. That's a 10.
Yes. Whoa. Yeah. I'm one game behind. One question left. I'll freeze.
You'll freeze. Yes. No, Angelo wants that 1-card lead as we get to the final question in sudden death. Julie, we asked 100 people, do you think there is life on other planets? How many people said yes?
Oh.
Quickly now.
With all the UFO business, I'd say many said yes, so I'm going to go 75.
75 said yes, there's life on other planets, Angelo.
I don't know. I'm going lower.
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 The actual number of people who believe there is life on other planets is 74. 1 lower. Angelo.
Woo!
Angelo, you want to play it with 2 cards or force Julie to play it with 3?
I'm going to pass that ball again. I'm going to pass
it
right to
her. All right, Julie, you did it before.
Yeah.
Call this.
I'm going to go lower.
Lower than a 10. It's a 9.
Lower.
Lower than a 9. It's a 6. 1 more and you're the champion. Higher than a 6? No, it's a 3. It's lower. We've got a tie.
Yeah.
1-1, $100 for each player, and we'll be right back right after this. Got a tie. Julian, Angelo, and I will be back next time to play the tiebreaker for the championship on Card Sharks. Bye-bye.
A representative of the studio audience will receive the new 22-volume World Book Encyclopedia, including research guide and index volume, easy-to-use and easy-to-read, furnished by World Book. And some of our contestants will receive Mary Kay Cosmetics, the everything you can be, with skincare and glamour cosmetics presented to you in your home by trained beauty consultants, Mary Kay Cosmetics, Dallas, Texas. And Cool Ray fashionable sunglasses that win admiring stares while protecting from annoying glare. 86 eye-catching style. See what you're missing with Cool Ray polarized sunglasses. And from Gallery of Homes, a book on home improvements. Gallery of Homes brokers. If you're selling or buying a home, you'll find they do their homework. And Quizel Lighting, your choice of one of these brass finished table lamps with bronze highlighting. Complements traditional and contemporary settings.
Hey, now you can play along with Win TV from your own PC. Register to play at GameShowNetwork.com, download the free software, then log on weekdays at 12 p.m. Eastern to watch, play, and win. Win TV Interactive, where a classic game show meets the future.
This is Gene Woods speaking for Card Sharks. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.